Hello, I want to show you how to make a ring oscillator using differential amplifier. I use this schematic. This is a Raja Facebook. So I will make ring oscillator like this, but I change the ISS into MOSFET. So I use MOSFET for adjust current that through in here. In the simulator, I use LTspice. Just right click again, and rename. Right click, rename. Okay. I need a source, voltage source. Thank you. just right click and decide 300. I give 300 and then I will browse upon the model of MOSFET in gmosedu.com. Choose the left book. And then this. Click gmosedu_model.txt. Then block all of the command line, copy, I make a folder, in here, there are four kind of MOSFET and contain of two models. The first model is level 3, contain of two level 3 and level 54, and there are four model, N model, P model, and I will use this model N_50nano and MOS level 54. Okay, then I save it. Current 3 volt. Control M. I'm sorry. Dot include and the name of the file. Level 3 and 54. Dot. Sorry. Dot text. Open about our model that we'll use in the simulation. N_50nano, right? I give 0.1 micro and for the white I give 10 micro. And then I copy the command line. Okay, just right click, paste in here. Actually, automatically, and the column of model length and width we change. Okay, then I'm pushing here, but I change the white medium, maybe about 20. Okay, after this I keep it 0.4 for bias voltage, and then I will make a pulse generator. So initial condition, actually it is a first condition in first time, set 0 and keep on, maybe 0.5 volt, and period 0.04, and T on. T on, give 0, half of the period 0.02. I think it's enough. Okay. When I right click again, then you hit right click. Okay, this is a value of our medium, MOSFET medium, and I will double click in here. Okay, it's been that value of value of MOSFET medium will be visible. Okay. Yeah. Sorry. Control, right click, double click. Okay. Control, right click, double click. Okay. I will drag the parameter. Forget to save it. Save as my desktop. Ring oscillator. Different. I will name it differential M. Different. Save. And then click. Run. I will give the stop time about 1 second. Okay. I will make a double panel in this window. So I click this window, then click plot setting, add plot pin. And I click the top of this pin, then I click input 1, I click input 2. Okay, then I click the button 1, and then I click input output 1 and output. Okay, then you can see that the amplitude of the input is about 0.5 volt, right? From here to here, right? From here to here. Okay? And the amplitude of the output is not amplifier, right? Because the input is greater than the output. Then I'm going to make the output greater than the input, maybe about 2 times of I will make the output voltage 2 times greater than the input. I'm back to my schematic. I will increase the white, medium, and the white. Maybe I give 100. Just copy. Output have increased, but it is not enough because the output voltage maybe same with the input voltage, right? About 0.5. So I will increase the tile MOSFET. I increase the white of MOSFET, maybe 300. Okay, then I will run. Okay, I think it's enough because the output approximation of the output about 1 volt, right? So we will back to the schematic and then I will drag this space direction. I save it. Okay, I think it's enough. And then I will make a duplicate file to save as diff_m_ symbol. diff_m_ We have two file. diff_m_ and diff_m. diff_m_ is exists, right? So I will open diff_m file. Modif the diff_m file into symbol. I will create a symbol of differential amplifier in this file. Okay, first I will cut the source. And then frequency, hierarchy, and open this shift symbol. Okay, just click. Couldn't find this shift symbol. Shall I try to automatically generate one? Yes. This is my symbol of differential amplifier. Then I will hide this this word. Just duplication, not visible. Okay. And then I think it is not a good indicator, right? Actually, in the place. Of indicator, I think it is not good. So usually ground put in the button, right? So I will click the track tool, click, I will make it in the top. That's it. Okay, and then and we will make a comparison between the symbol and the schematic. Okay, this is a graph of the schematic, so I will make graph of that symbol. First I symbol, right, that we have done. Okay, now click here. Okay, now click, and then I will make a I need three differential amplifier here, because I will direct to make the oscillator. Okay. And then I will open Raja Facebook. Okay, this is our schematic, and you can see that the output one is connected to the input 2, and the output 2 is connected to the input 1. I think the next stage is same connection, have same connection, right? I will zoom out. 1. The output 2 is going to connect to input 2. Okay. And I need ground in here. VDD port. Okay, I think it's enough. Oh, I forget one step. I have to type space direction, right? VDD to VDD, from VDD to ground, DC current source, revolve. I think it's enough. Oh, maybe tran. What's it? Control M. No. I think it's enough. Okay, I put it here. Then I hit run. Oh, sorry. I forget to give the output port. Okay. Output. Sorry, I put it here. Right click, rename. The stop time is about 20 nanoseconds. I think it's enough, 20 nano. Okay. Oh, I will plot the output 1 first and plot the output 2. Okay. Right. So the output swing, the magnitude of the output swing is from maybe from 1.95 maybe till 2.74. It is not a good output, because the good output is almost same from 0 to VDD, almost same. So your homework is change your homework is change the magnitude of differential amplifier. Maybe you change the resistor, and change the medium, length and wide, maybe you change the bias voltage, maybe you you change the resistor into the PMOS. I think it's a good idea. Or maybe you give the current mirror to substitute the bias voltage, so you can control the current that through in this wire. Okay, and then I will show you how to measure the frequency, but I'm not sure is this way. First you just right click in here and choose the first and second, then you will find this strip line, right? And you click and drag right and left. You just concentrate your eye in this row, frequency row. So I just click and drag to the left or to the right. Okay, the maximum value is 60.8 gigahertz, right? So, but I don't know. This is a right way or false way to measure the frequency output. But I have browsed this how and I have browsed the step of how to measure the frequency using LTspice, but I just find this step, so but I'm not sure. So if you have an idea or have an acknowledgement about how to measure the frequency output in using LTspice, please comment in the comment column. Okay. I think it's enough. See you and happy simulating.